Harry Eastlip was born in Germany in 1836 and came to this country when he was 10 years old. He worked in the newspaper industry, and as a young man, he moved to Altoona to start the Evening Mirror in 1872. He would later change the name to the Altoona Mirror in 1874. One of Harry's grandchildren was J.E. Holzinger. Known as Ted, he was born in 1903 and followed his grandfather into the newspaper business. He also earned a bachelor's degree from Penn State in 1925. During the Great Depression, many Altoonians knew a college education was not possible for them, but Ted set his mind to change that. Known as a founder of the Altoona campus, he and other community leaders convinced Penn State officials to locate a branch center in Altoona. And on September 13, 1939, the Altoona Undergraduate Center, or AUC, was established. The inaugural class included 119 students and employed 9 faculty members, with Robert E. Ica being the school's first director. AUC's first home was an abandoned grade school on Lexington Avenue and 10th Street, known as the Webster Building. $5,000 was raised by the community to renovate the building. No small feat, given the country was 10 years deep into the Depression. Another $3,000 was raised the following year to buy the old Madison Grade School, and it was turned into a sophomore science laboratory. However, when the United States entered World War II, the Altoona Undergraduate Center almost shut their doors when enrollment shrank to 40 students. To counter this, the Citizens Advisory Board purchased and operated the Annie C. Wolfe's Women's Dormitory from 1944 to 1947. This was the first resident hall and allowed women outside of Altoona to attend the school. This helped keep the school going, and when the war skyrocketed, and soon the small campus was at capacity with students. They needed to expand, but where?
Before there was a Penn State Altoona, there was the Ivyside Amusement Park. It was started by a pharmacist from Altoona named E. Raymond Smith. The park was opened in 1925. It consisted of a 650-foot-long pool that was 186 feet wide. At its capacity, it accommodated 5,000 people. However, with the Depression in the 30s and the gasoline rationing during the Second World War, it killed business. And when E. Raymond passed in November 1945, the Smith family wanted to sell the park, but to who? There were several suitors for the property, but Mrs. Smith wanted the place to go to the college and sold the entire 40 acres and buildings for what was owed in back taxes, which was $36,000. $50,000 was raised by the community to buy the land and to renovate the old bathhouse. This is why the Altoona Undergraduate Center was affectionately known as Bathhouse U. The university made the move in 1948. The bathhouse contained classrooms, the library, administration offices, biology lab, physics lab, and graphic arts lab. Other buildings that were revamped was the Ivyside Building, known as Ivy Hall, that was the student union building from 1948 to 1964 and was demolished in 1990. The only two buildings that are still left from 1948 are the Pine Building that served as the park's concession stand and the Elm Building, originally a shooting gallery and was first remodeled as chemistry laboratories, then repurposed as faculty offices, a kiln studio, costume shop, and the maintenance department's carpentry shop.
In 1953, Penn State earned university status and their affiliated centers could now award associate's degrees. Enrollment was constantly growing, and a campaign for Ivyside's first permanent building began to materialize when $550,000 was raised in 1956. When fundraising stalled, faculty and students went door to door. One account has fundraisers going into a music store for a donation and ended up with a piano for the campus. When funds were finally secured, the doors to the E. Raymond Smith Building were opened on September 15, 1958. This is also when the Altoona Undergraduate Center became to be known as the Altoona Campus, recently designated by the trustees at Penn State University. According to Altoona's first employee and associate director, Robert L. Smith, the new building was our prize, our first permanent building. And as the new came in, the old went out. Ivy Hall in 1958, and the bathhouse was demolished in 1959. Although it took 20 years to get the first new building, they started being built one right after the other. Within 6 years, the Slept Student and Faculty Center in Oak Resonant Hall opened in 1964. With its reflecting pool, it became a proud landmark of the campus, and Slept's design has won many awards and was used as a prototype for other campuses.
By 1966, 2,000 students were enrolled at the Altoona campus, a 1,000 in residence and another 1,000 in continuing education. In 1969, the Robert E. Ica Library opened, named in honor of the first director of the Altoona campus. He was originally the first director of the Penn State Hazleton branch and was asked to Altoona to establish the campus in 1939. He did so until his retirement in 1968. Also, in 1999, construction on the first interdenominational chapel built on a Commonwealth campus was started. The Edith Davis Eve Memorial Chapel is a 75-foot tall, 10-buttressed panel tower separated by stained glass windows, done by the world-renowned artist Jean-Jacques Duval, who has done installations all over the world, including the Vatican. Along with its 50-bell carillon system, that was designed by the inventor, Schumerich Carillons Incorporated. The Memorial Chapel overlooking the reflecting pool is another landmark that makes the Altoona campus unique.
Thank you for watching a brief history about the Penn State Altoona campus. Please check out our other videos on historical features of the campus and oral histories from the people who helped build it.